And certainly this indicates that we are ready for freedom. And we're ready to march forward.
Yeah, I see that so often. Guys just get so focused on their big build, they run out of money, or it takes them 2 or 3 years, and in the meantime some kids come here and spent like 2 or 3 grand, done 1,000 laps and become a great drifter. You know, it's like, who's doing it right? I think you really want to just get the laps in rather than being too focused on doing some big crazy build. Ebisu circuit is kind of like a theme park for cars. You've got numerous tracks, I think I've got about 7 or 8 here, 2 dedicated grip tracks, the rest are all available for drift. We have everything from a very basic skid pan setup, there's 2 of them, you pay $20 approximately, and you can drift all day in the skid pans, right up to the D1 GP Manami, the south course. So you can drift the same track all the D1 guys do, you pay $80, and that's you all day, you can drift away. It originally started as an off-road track, I think, back in the 80s and 90s in the boom era. And Kumakubo's interest in drifting, or had an interest in drifting, so they started to build some purpose-built drift tracks, and it just expanded and expanded to where we're at now.
Shizu! Yeah! Hi, Matsuri Party!
This is the original Drift Matsuri, Matsuri being festival. We hold 3 a year. We have one in the spring, one in the summer, one in the autumn every year. What we do at that time is close all the tracks and make them available for drifting only. That includes the 2 big high-speed drift courses, so you can drift 4th gear. And for 36 hours non-stop, we drift all day, all night. It's a great atmosphere, barbecues, everyone has a great time. So yeah, it's become very, very popular, and you hear of Matsuris all around the world now. And this is because this is the original one, this is where it all started, this is the original Drift Matsuri.
So in Japan, it's usually a 2.5 or a 3-litre turbo. To keep the thing on power, you've really got to have an aggressive driving style, whereas around the rest of the world, it tends to be a V8. Now, I definitely agree that for competition, having a V8 is a big advantage, because you don't have to work so hard to keep the thing within its torque range. But that all comes back to style, as to what would you rather see, somebody who's aggressively developing a car and trying to get the most out of it, or a car that's easily doing it.
I don't know much about the grassroots scene in the US, but as far as the grassroots scene goes here, a lot of guys just come to hang out with their friends. It's a big thing. Like, I think overseas, it's how quickly you can get up to battle level. I'm ready to fight someone. I want to battle with someone. Whereas here, how they learn is groups of three or four, and they drift together. And that's how they get real comfortable being close with a car without trying to attack or beat the other car, but just mimicking the other car. I think overseas, there's so much focus on being ready to battle as opposed to just being able to maintain a drift behind a car.
I seen AK-47, I seen sawed-off shotguns, I seen all of this, I seen dynamite on the street.
アルビ21かな、やっぱり。パワーも出るし、音がいいから、アルビ26は好きだけど、アッパーアメリカンブイ8はかっこいいよね。このスタッフかな。チームオレンジが一番大事にしてる、その努力とスタイルは、お客さんが喜んでくれて、ハッピーになってくれるのが一番大事にしてる。アメリカンスタイルよ、フォーミュラDのスタイルとかは、やっぱり、フォーミュラDプロモーションが上手だから、そのフォーミュラDはすごくかっこよく見えるし、で、やっぱり車もパワーだし、すごくかっこいいよね。日本のスタイルは、やっぱりすごくテクニックとかを大事にはしてるよね。でも日本の、そうだね、今の D1 はちょっと違うかな。
Team Orange has a t-shirt that they created to kind of explain this, where as a car's coming into a corner, you're drifting, and the moment you transition to throttle, you're now power sliding. And they want to make a clear, I guess, definition between those two elements to a track. Because once you're on throttle, there's very little, very little skill in just putting your foot down and holding on. And so a lot of the Japanese tracks are designed to showcase the skill that you're using coming into the corner. It's a big fly, an aggressive switch. And so they designed their tracks to actually highlight those elements of the style.
Yeah. adventure. Talking to the rap inventor. Nigga with the game type, fifth that flame right. Got my name right. B-I-double-G-I-E. Iced out, lights out, me and D. Leo. Getting head for some shit, you know. D is all about the gender. Nobody do it better. What I'm about to tell, strictly for the rapper. Women and the weed. Sticky green. No seeds, bitch, please.
What's up, guys? It's Robin Ishida. We're here in Japan at Daigo Saito's shop, Fat 5 Racing. Maybe we'll check out some of the cool cars. Well, actually, the crazy cars he has here. This is where he builds all the cars, the Lambos, the FD cars, the D1 cars. He also has his D1 car, the crazy 1,000 kilogram, 1,000 horsepower Mark II in display. It's kind of a nice facility. You never see big shops like this in Japan, so it's kind of one of a kind. Fat 5 Racing, I guess their main thing they do is they build cars for customers. So this is one of the cars that they're finishing up. I guess he'll build it to whatever needs you want. Mostly drift cars, like the Lambo and any exotic cars. He'll come up with some kind of idea to make it work so it can drift.
The most important thing would be to go out with your friends and have fun in similar cars instead of trying to one up each other and build, insanely high power drift cars with, Driftworks this, WiseFab this, V8. I think just keep it simple and concentrate on driving rather than spending 2 years, 3 years, 4 years in a garage trying to build the ultimate drift car. Because like 3 years down the track, when you're a better driver, you might look back and say, I built that car totally wrong to what my capabilities were back then.
That's how the world is at a fingertips now.